Just I'll mention one interesting story is related to the Omani values. Just 1 week before I come here, I was at Sultan Qaboos Grand Mosque and particularly in Islamic Information Center, and I was approached by two couple. So they sat next to me and I asked them, where are they from? They said, we are from England. Oh, I'm going to be in England in 1 week. What do you do? I'm going to present a paper. What's that about? About Omani values. I'll start. So the lady said to me, do Omani values overlap with the British values, which we spoke about earlier? So I said, well, you need to tell me first about the British values, what the British values are, so I can answer the question. She mentioned a number of them. Of them is self-deprecation. So I said to her, it seems they are overlapping. I wrote yesterday, I was writing a research. So I wrote a story of an early Omani and Ibadi scholar who was nicknamed Al-Asam, which means the deaf. So he is in reality wasn't deaf, but once he was approached by a woman, apparently she might be asking him a religious question, but unwillingly she passed wind. So this scholar, in order not to embarrass her, he pretend that he's deaf and he had never even heard her question. From that time on, this scholar was called the deaf up to date. So